Now the side seam, both sewn, and these are hemmed all the way around, just folded twice and overcast. And now I shall make this split. The split is there, I'll just fix it. This is the front, this is the back. Yeah, nu skal det gå bort. And two. Du må gå væk. Du må gå væk. They should be sewn like this, so they overlap like this. The flap is going to the front, outside, and to the back, inside. So I simply overcast, and overcast. Was the sides. And now we shall make the neckline. Now there's only a square hole, way too little to get a head in through it. So now I shall split up here on the body fabric and in here, under here, in the lining. That is maybe the function of the whole thing with the lining. You see? I shall cut up here in the main and in here in the lining. And then I shall add this tape around. So I continue that line with the seam allowance as far down as possible, really, so I don't cut in the maybe 1 centimeter from this. That was one, and also in the other. Remember to do it in both sides, different sides, one there. So now it's open. And then first thing to do is to can take this away a little. Now I shall take in a tiny seam allowance here. And overcast it so that the lining and the body fabric is sitting together there. When you come down to the last centimeter, the seam allowance on this piece that I bend in are getting smaller and smaller and smaller. So here it is in zero. So it's important that you make the stitches here quite close, quite small. So you sort of make a security of the bottom of the split here. Like so. Now it is attached, the front is attached to the lining in one side and one of the flap is finished. And now I continue around here. So I bend in twice as small as I can, like this, and then I continue with small overcast. Make some extra here in the bottom so you secure it. Now when you come to the top, do the same one more time around the corner, two, and one more. So got in the end here. So many layers right here. So, all the way over to here, to the corner. Also here you go up in zero, that corner. And in the end here, you can just sew around some stitches. this corner will be quite exposed when the shirt is finished. One side finished, and then we shall do the same with the other one. So this time it is, we have to turn inside out. Now, this is the lining, this is the body part, so it's the same, exactly the same. You turn this in, overcast from here to there, and then you continue around with the double turn in, overcast all the way. So now the two flaps are on, and the last thing to do is to sew on the tie or the tape around the neckline here. As I said, mentioned earlier, in the find, this was made from the serge, but since we cannot use serge in modern fabric, I simply cut out a normal tape, and then I have to sew it in a little different way. They use the silver sides and sew it directly on the top here. We won't. We'll put it as a normal tape on. But first thing to do is to find in the back. It's here. And then I measure from center back down to the first corner and out in this flap, or what you call it. And then in this corner there shall be a knot made from this. So I will take 5 centimeters extra. That's what go in the neckline. And then I do it as long as I want, which at least is like this. So first thing to do is to sew this one together. Bend in both sides and overcast it like a tape, up to here first, and then we put it on the shirt. Oh, I'm tired. It's so warm here. Can you hear that? That's a good sound. It was my rhubarber cake that finished. It's finished. Will you look at that? With vanilla ice cream, I guess. To lick a cake. She don't understand. And it looks good. Harvested, new harvested rhubarb from the neighbor's garden. That's a good neighbor. She is warm too. Little ram, Simba. Simba, little ram. Wow. Yeah, I don't bend anything in here in the end. I just start. And when this shirt is finished, I tie a little knot here. I'm not sure if they did that in the Vivo shirt, but I do it because I made those for children and they take out the tie of those small knots. It is a nightmare to get them back in. Just small overcast. So now I'm up to start of the neckline. And then I sew it on like a tape, like you have done, I'm sure, many times. From the right side, on the little flaps, on the little line where we did the bending in and overcasting, what do I normally do? Yes, of course. I'm sorry. I overcast it on, but only in the one side. You see, I open it, so I sew it in one side, and then I take the other. As I will normally add a tape. Small stitches. To the corner, and then you have to stop there. So now I am in the corner of the flap. I'm here, and here's going to be a knot for the tying system. It's hard to explain. You see this is going through a knot. That's the one we shall make now, this one. So first I now sew only in the tape together again as I did before. Then both sides in and then together, and only in the tape. So I sew sort of the tape that I shall go into the knot, that shall be the knot now. 4 centimeters approximately. So, and now I simply not do the knot, simple knot. One, that's it. And make sure the needles and thread come through in the right way. So, take care that it's not too big. I think these on the blue one are not too big. And now I'm going to add the tape as you do normally, all the way around, and do the knot here. Sew it on here again as we did before, and sew it all the way out. And then the line is finished. Or she'll just put them through the knots then. But first thing, find the top of this. Where is that? That's there. Now you understand what I meant by this is an exposed area. So you have to make sure you have the whole seam in it. Both front and back here. Into the tape. And now simply running stitch, small running stitch. To add the tape to the neckline. See? All the way around. All the way up there, there, and down there. And here you do the same. Do the tape only for 4 centimeters, make the knot, continue out here, continue out there. And after that, you bend it double to the back and overcast inside, like you would do on a normal tape. But now it's time for rhubarb pie and a nice cup of tea. See you after. Welcome back. Good cake and nice tea. And now I have sewn the tailbone all the way around. And no knots yet here. So those small knots were made in the side, in the corners. Now the last thing to do with the neckline is to put those into those. And it's not very easy unless you have made them very big. So, good. It's a clever thing. And now, because they are not easy to put in, I always make a knot there. I'm not sure if they did that in the fine, but I guess they did. It's practical and it's decorative. So, that was the neckline. Brilliant. So the next thing is to do is to sew the sleeves.